Hello, comic book fans. Here's Earl Grey. Today I don't want to talk about the comics below here, but about the three above, which contain comics from a guy whose art I first encountered in one of the Fantagraphics mini comics collection here. This is volume 2 or 3 of them. And when I recently said in my video about Kush mini comics that mini comics usually, not the ones from Kush, but usually tend for me to be connected with a lot more violence and sex, then it's one of these collection or all of three of them who I had in mind as well, because there's a lot of violence and sex and more adult stuff. Nothing wrong with that, but once in a while I do like some more sensible, timid souls who aren't interested, at least in their art, in these kind of things. And even though Thought Cloud shrines the contribution of Theo Ellsworth, here was not so much a comic, but a series of drawings loosely connected in depicting the process of thinking, what happens in your head when you're creative. Even though it wasn't a comic, the intricate horror wacky style, there's urgency to get stuff that you're imagining onto the paper, that rang a bell, that rang true to me, and I did like it a lot, and this was some of the best stuff in these three collections. So, and when I saw the name Ellsworth in the offerings of Kush, it rang a bell as well. So I thought, oh, hey, you know that guy, and interesting, he does comics with a real story now. But maybe more about that later, about these two comics. First, I want to talk about Capacity, one soft cover or hard cover or something in between, put out by Secret Acres. And this is kind of interesting work. Somehow it starts like the Fantagraphics collection, his Theo Ellsworth's contribution there. Actually, I've shown you this drawing some seconds before. But it contains a series of mini comics that Theo Ellsworth did. And this was a good thing, because these mini comics, these Capacity stuff here, helped him to give him some rhythm in his narration. It put the pressure on him to speak, so to speak, to create something that has a start, middle, and end, which is a good thing when you have such an overflowing imagination like Theo Ellsworth obviously has. And sometimes this helped him to do even some more reduced stuff, which is not a bad thing. You can't read for hours and hours these intricate horror wacky, highly detailed drawings, even though I do like them a lot. By the way, if you like Jim Woodring's comics, for instance, I'm pretty certain that you will like Theo Ellsworth's comics as well. And this collection of Capacity mini comics is closely interwoven with some parts about the biography of him. For instance, there were some times when he doesn't feel too good, had a bit of a heartache, obviously, and then he started to draw some more depressive, less detailed, but nevertheless interesting art. You understand why he drew the stuff this way, and later on, when he found the love of his life, or at least a nice girl to live with, and he isn't living out of his car anymore, He does stuff like that. What I suspect has been going outside while I'm asleep. Yeah. What happens when you're dreaming? And that's the central question here. Here's a story about a guy who chases his dreams in the morning, and they escape all into some sort of cave, which is a nice idea. And by the way, another comparison that you can draw is Where the Wild Things Roam, or however the story is titled. But now to the two books here from Kusch, maybe starting with the Kusch Mono one, An Exorcism. This is one of their more thicker outputs, even though it's still mini comic book size. And it's in color, An Exorcism. And Theo Ellsworth makes great use of color, the color. Here's this guy who's trapped on his bed, which turns out to be some four-legged vehicle of sorts. In this case, it's pretty typical for Theo Ellsworth to strap the main character onto something and go with him through some weird worlds, start a trip, and he can't do anything but to endure whatever happens outside him. And this has actually the vibe of a bad LSD trip of sorts, or Nemo in Slumberland. As long as he is trapped on this bed here, you can say this is a take on Nemo in Slumberland. And things start rolling, literally, and we go on the right with this guy here. And you really can see the work of an artist who knows what he's doing. It's not just this fooling around and filling the page with some scribble. Even though it's hard to tell you what he is actually going on, there's clearly a plan to all the narration, and keeping it silent, I think, helped a lot. In earlier days, Theo Ellsworth would have felt the urge, I think, to put in all expositional text boxes to describe the stuff beneath, but it's much more fun to make sense out of this as well. And this is one of these reading markers that Kusch puts into your books, which is a nice little detail. And so, yeah, this is one thing really to hunt down. And this is Birthday, Theo Ellsworth's contribution to Kusch's Mini Kusch series. This is a real mini comic, if you will. Cardboard cover with 24 pages stapled onto the cardboard, and a pretty similar story, you might say, but nevertheless totally different, about this guy who endures some kind of space cosmic initiation process. His thoughts, who hover brain-like above his head, are put into this fish thing here, and yeah, and at a certain point it becomes pretty indescribable. Crippable, not to, you can't describe it anymore. So I really like this little trip through Theo Ellsworth's brain. That was my little take on Theo Ellsworth's offerings so far. He has done a lot more, and actually had done a very nice internet site where you can order more stuff from him. I won't do it because the shipping towards Germany is so so high that I really can't afford it. But I'll wait and look out for maybe some opportunity to get more of his stuff over here. So that's enough for now, I think. Thanks for listening and watching. Goodbye.